من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله أحمده وأستعينه وأستهديه وأستغفره وأؤمن به جل وعلا ولا أكفره، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. قل إن صلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين لا شريك له، وبذلك أمرت أنا والمسلمين. أما بعد أيها المسلمون، أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله عز وجل في السر وفي العلانية، في السراء وفي الضراء، لأن تقوى الله هي المخافة من الجليل والعمل بالتنزيل والرضا بالقليل والاستعداد ليوم الرحيل. ومن يتقي الله يجعل له مخرجا ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. My dear Muslims, the theme of the subject of today is something related to التكافل فيما بيننا كمسلمين. التكافل. I'm going to take only one aspect or two aspects of takaful, although there are maybe about half a dozen or more varieties of takaful. And takaful is how to help each other as Muslims. And we work together to help each other, because we don't know when a crisis might happen to any one of us, socially, culturally, emotionally, death, and financially, other legally, and no one government is going to help us, we have to help each other. And for that reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed us in Surah At-Tawbah, the repentance chapter, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم والمؤمنون والمؤمنات بعضهم أولياء بعض يأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر ويقيمون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة ويطيعون الله ورسوله أولئك سيرحمهم الله إن الله عزيز حكيم. In this ayah, in Surah At-Tawbah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us that not only Muslims to Muslims, but mu'min to mu'min. And think of it, in order to be mu'min, you have to have the higher degree of Islam to accept and to practice Islam and then go to Arkan al-Iman. 6. إيمان بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر والقضاء والقدر خيره وشره. If we are of that type inshallah, then he says مؤمنون and مؤمنات. The believers, the faithful men and women are responsible to each other to help one another and to assume that legal responsibility in taking care of each other. Plus, they are supposed to go and make da'wah and inform people what is halal and encourage them. يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ and يَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. And anytime you see something bad, you have to stop it with your tongue, with your writing, and or if you have a government, then you have the power of the government. Nevertheless, but you have to also يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ. You have to perform salat 5 times a day, and you have to come for salat al-jum'ah in order to practice that you are part of a mu'min. وَيَأْتُونَ الزَّكَاةِ and they pay the charity. No, it's not charity, it's an obligation that you have to pay it in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, zakat, 2.5% of your savings. وَيُطِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ. Whatever comes in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we say سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا أُفْرَانَكَ رَبَّنَا وَإِلَيْكَ الْمَصِيرِ. Yes, Ya Allah, we have heard, we have listened to what you have revealed in the Quran, and we obey and we follow. And whatever you, Ya Rasulullah, explained it for us, we obey, we follow, and we do not object. Then and then rahmah of Allah comes to us, inshallah, in this world and the hereafter. Now also the hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reported through An-Nu'man ibn Bashir radiallahu anhuma, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مَثَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي تَوَادِّهِمْ وَتَرَاحُمِهِمْ وَتَعَاطُفِهِمْ. 3 factors, huh? كمثل الجسد إذا اشتكى منه عضو تداعى له سائر الجسد بالسهر والحمى. That the similitude of those believers, he didn't mention Muslim, he mentioned mu'min. means higher level. Which means you have to assume your responsibility. في توادهم الود. What is ود? You have to show your mercy. No, it's not mercy. ود, how you talk to each other. How to share and care for those who are less fortunate than you. That is ود. The second one, تراحمهم, رحمة, mercy. We have to have mercy toward each other. We don't shout, we don't yell, we don't spank, we don't beat. Luckily, in the Islamic teaching, no battering of women and no child abuse and no even against each other. We have to have mercy. Otherwise, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose for Himself in reading Quran after ta'awuz, a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, He said, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. He could have said, you have to say Bismillah al-Azim, al-Jabbar, al-Muntaqim. No, he said, that is scary. Although he is, but he said, I want you to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His mercy. Inna rahmati sabaqat ghadabi. Even the rahmah of Allah supersede when He wants to penalize somebody, He said, no, wait a minute. Rahmah, mercy should go to them. Maybe they come and ask Allah forgiveness and repent. Even, therefore, number one is al-wud, how we can have wud toward each other, talk to each other very politely, feel sympathy for each other, and how we can care and share for each other. Number two, rahmah, mercy, wa ta'atufihim. You have to have af. You see somebody less fortunate than you, you should feel sorry for him. Wallah, I feel sorry for him, bye bye. It's not my business. No. If it is not your business, you are not part of the Muslim Ummah of Mu'mineen, that we are responsible for each other. Therefore, even af has to be toward each other, to feel sorry for anyone who is less fortunate than you. When somebody is sick, you should feel sorry for them and make dua shifa. When somebody dies, you should feel sorry and make dua maghfirah for them. When you see somebody homeless, go and help him. When you see somebody jobless, go and help him. When you hear the immigration now laws are talking about the illegal or no legal, whatever, you should go and find who is illegal. Can I sponsor him legally through me or through my society or through masjid or through any business person? I feel sorry for any faithful person who is really devoted in the community and he needs our support and we don't support him. Well, that's not my business. Whose business? Which government is going to take care of any Muslim here in America? So number three is ta'atuf. So the similitude of all these characters, كمثل الجسد إذا اشتكى منه عضو تداعى له سائر الجسد بالسهر والحمى. Whenever any crisis is going to happen to anyone, everybody has to say, I want to help. Like when your finger of your toe, one toe finger is paining you, or a tooth is paining you, the whole body is aching. Means the whole Muslim Ummah should be aching. The whole Muslim Ummah should feel. He said, Bissahar, when you have pain in your tooth, you cannot sleep all night long. Even if you take antibiotics tonight, it might not solve in 1 hour, one night. So the whole Muslim Ummah should feel sorry for any one of us who is in desperate need to say, I'm not going to sleep all night long till I solve her problem or his problem. Is it not true, Umar al-Khattab radiallahu anhu used to go in the city of Medina every night and listen if there is anybody in need, any child crying? Why? Even a child, if a child is crying out of hunger, he used to carry the food himself with his wife and cook the food and feed the children. That is the attitude of a Muslim Ummah. Nowadays we see so many are in need. We turn our faith, Wallahi Allah, I cannot. But in the Day of Judgment, see what will happen. Plus, وَتِلْكَ الْأَيَّامُ نُدَاوِلُهَا بَيْنَ النَّاسِ يَوْمٌ لَكُمْ وَيَوْمٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. One day for you, one day for the others. One day you might be struck because you say it's not my business, I turn my back, and nobody knows, so what? But Allah knows that you can help and you did not help. Now, even humma means you have high temperature, 100 degrees, no, 101, 102, 103. The whole body is aching and also high temperature, you cannot sleep. I wish we reach that level to help each other. Now also another hadith reported to Anas radiallahu anhu, and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. متفق عليه. That those who claim themselves faithful believers, he said, you are not faithful believers until and unless you like for your brothers and sisters what you like for yourself. What do you like for yourself? To have a house? You should have that feeling for every faithful believer. You like to have a good car? I wish I can help everybody. You have not to lose your job? The same thing you should feel for everybody. You like for them what you like for yourself. And don't feel jealous if somebody is driving Mercedes or Cadillac and you are driving even Volkswagen. So what? It's a means of transportation. Never ever you look at those who are higher than you in finance or in luxury. Look at those who are less fortunate than you, then you'll be grateful to Allah, Ya Allah. You want to be grateful more? Go to the hospital every day and you cry for those people and say, Alhamdulillah, Ya Allah. Please Allah, don't make me to reach that level. Last night, 11 o'clock, a medical doctor called me, somebody between life and death, and they want to give him resuscitation. He said no, because with resuscitation, he has cancer, and they said he is going to feel more pain with the drug and resuscitation. Leave me alone, let me die peacefully rather than elongating my suffering. I am suffering. What should he do? I said, Wallahu, read Surah Yasin. When you read Surah Yasin, it's either Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save him and recuperate him, or he will make him to go peacefully to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We did it many times to so many friends here. I still remember two cases in our community. One brother between life and death, we read Surah Yasin so many times, he is now stronger than any one of us, mashallah. He was dead. No one gave him any chance of another day. Another brother, may Allah bless his soul, we read Surah Yasin for him, and Allah took his soul very peacefully, instead of staying vegetable. So the idea of the Sahari wal Humma, you will never appreciate what Allah has given us unless you go and see somebody else. You want more? Yes. Day before, we had to bury a brother who had cancer. He's in his 40s. He left his wife and three children, little children. She cannot collect any money. He didn't plan anything. And she cannot go and ask anybody. What should we do? We Muslims. We buried him together. His wife now is lonely. You want her to be homeless? You want her to be with the children, orphans, seeking help in the street, sitting at the street and extending her head at the corner, say, please, people, give me $1. We cried. We cried together day before. Don't we have social services to help our communities, to help each other? Or we should wait till the crisis happens, like what happens in the Muslim world. We leave the crisis to take place. When the crisis is there, we try to help relief organization. Why don't we organize ourselves way in advance, and each and every one of us will take care of it on a regular basis, and whenever a crisis happens for any sister, for any child, for anyone, there is a special fund. Every week, more than half a dozen families are calling. Either the sister is in trouble financially or medically and she cannot have this or that, or somebody is homeless, somebody is jobless, somebody... We are not a government and we don't have a budget. We don't have even budget for our masjid to take care of the rent every month. I don't know. I cry. I said, I'm not the Khalifa and there is no Khalifa. I'm not responsible, but all of us are responsible. Usually I hate to talk on this subject. Every week I talk on spirituality, 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 to bring our spirit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and live in peace and harmony, because you are coming for the love of Allah to enjoy the spirit. But during the week, we stay here till midnight. One family came on Monday till midnight. We stayed 3.5 hours to solve their problem. They came for talaq, 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 100%. There is no way but talaq. I had to cry on his behalf, on her relatives, on his relatives, as if I am the criminal. But alhamdulillah, 12:30, everything was over. And everything came back 180 degrees. They went back together, peacefully and happily. It's not easy. It's not easy to solve any problem of any Muslim community, but somebody has to cry. Some of the brothers who are loving friends, they tell me, "Akhi, how come we don't see you Friday here? Every Friday." I say, "Come with me every day and you stay with me till midnight every day here and you see how much we are solving problem after problem without a government, without anything, not only from the community. From Seattle to Florida, people are calling and they are having problem, we try to solve their problem." But somebody has to work as a team, not as individual. Because individual, when he dies, somebody has to assume it. We have to work as a jama'ah. For this reason, I recited for you the first ayah, وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضٍ. We are to support each other, to help each other, to work together for the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in this particular takaful, responsibility of helping, I said I take at least one or two. The idea of economic helping to our communities, one is zakat. Most of the Muslims, they pay their zakat in Ramadan, and then we spend it in Ramadan, the whole year is over. But we should have something. I still remember with my mashayikh in the old country and my reading the books of fiqh, there are a good number of Muslim ulama, they said the zakat can be paid on a monthly basis, on a weekly basis, because there are needy Muslims throughout the whole year. How can you do it? And you don't know whether you can live for another year to save money to pay, because the necessities of life are too many and the zinat al-hayat is too much. So it's better that we help those who need the help on a weekly, monthly basis, zakat. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also gave us the idea of sadaqah, and He gave us the idea of fitrah only in Ramadan. But kafara, how many of us make mistake and to be forgiven by Allah, you have to pay sadaqah, you have to be kafara. It's not sadaqah, kafara. Suppose you promise somebody to do something you did not do. Either you pay kafara, so as Allah will wipe your mistake, that kafara to feed 10 people from morning till evening, 3 meals a day for 10 people. That is kafara. You don't want, or you cannot afford to pay money, fast 3 days. For anyone who promises to do something and he does not do it for one reason or the other. So Allah gave us two choices, either you fast 3 days or you feed 10 people from morning till evening, 3 meals. Of course there is earth also, living trust. Nowadays they call us in America living trust. Your earth, if you think that your money and your asset, everything for your wife and children, well and good. But maybe your wife and children may not make sadaqah on your behalf. Who knows? Your children may not practice Islam as much as you hope. They may not pay any sadaqah on your behalf when you are there. Why don't you allocate? And lovingly, Islam has allowed 1/3 of your asset to be donated, to be given after you die, if he said it. Who knows? Sadaqa jariya, build a masjid, build a school, build a hospital, a clinic, anything and everything. Do something before you die, because you don't know who is going to make sadaqa for you when you die. The orphans, who's going to take care of the orphan? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in Surah Al-Duha, فَأَمَّا الْيَتِيمَ فَلَا تَقْهَرْ. Yatim, don't leave him alone. See how many hundreds of thousands of children orphaned in the Muslim world because of so many varieties of crises from war and whatnot, are being sold and built by non-Muslims to make them non-Muslim, to make them the enemies of Islam, to fight Islam and Muslims. Why? Because we are not taking care of them. As if we don't have the money to take care of them in the Muslim world. Here some of the boys and girls, children, are being taken away after their parents are dead for car accident. Who's going to take care of them? But their parents are dead. Where is the Muslim community that will say, "I will assume the responsibility"? Oh, but you are not registered as a family counselor or as a social service to help your community. And nobody is writing a will that, "Please, when I die, please bury me Muslim." We have a crisis. A Muslim married a non-Muslimah. And she wants now to bury him her own way. Christian way. to take him to the church. Ya akhi, make an agreement. Who told you to marry a non-Muslim to start with? And why to marry a non-Muslim when we have plenty of Muslim girls? And to marry a non-Muslim, make sure, make a will, even if she becomes Muslim. Who knows, at the time of death, she might change her mind. Make a will, notarize, give it to the lawyer, and then give it to your community center, make sure that you'll be buried Islamically. I have seen so many crises in Chicago. A loving Muslim was brought his body to our area to bury him. His wife has put a cross on his chest and a cross on the casket, whether you like it or not. Another brother died in Chicago, and instead of being buried in Jannat al-Baqiyah, Jannat al-Baqiyah, next to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, next to all the Sahaba, his wife, because she was European, she said, no, what is Jannat al-Baqiyah, who cares for it? She brought him to Chicago. We want to bury him in a Muslim cemetery. She said, no, I want to bury him with his professional background, architect. Okay, go with the architect. In the day of judgment, will be someone with the non-Muslim architect. Is this the way that we have to work in this part of the world when there is no Muslim government to take care of us? And 2 days ago, the owner of the cemetery told us that lady, non-Muslim, want to bury her husband her own way. He said, listen, this is America, this is not a Muslim country, the wife takes over everything, not even your father, your mother, your children have right on it, your wife is the upper hand on it. So when I read this, when I see the crisis after crisis happening every day, who is responsible? No one. Okay, no, leave it alone. No. إذا القوم نادوا من فتن خلت أنني عنيت فلم أكسل ولم أتبلد. When the community is asking, where is the young boy? We're a young man. Where is the person to take? Every Muslim used to say, me number one. Me number one. I want to do this. I want to do it for the love of Allah. Not for the sake of anybody. In the day of judgment, Allah is going to come here. He had this golden opportunity, you refused. I made him sick, I made him to die, I made him less fortunate than you. Why you didn't come forward? Wallahi, wallahi. What wallahi, there is no. The other thing that I have to remind myself, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us, إِذَا مَاتَ ابْنُ آدَمٌ قَطَعَ عَمَلُهُ إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثَ صَدَقَ جَارِيَةٌ أَوْ عِلْمٍ يَنْتَطَعُ بِهِ أَوْ وَلَدٌ صَالِحٌ يَدُوبُ. When you are going to die, nothing is going to go with you to your grave. No life insurance. Those who are giving us life insurance is useless for me or for you. It's not for you. Life insurance is not for you. It's for the inheritors to inherit much more than what you are leaving there. But I want a life insurance that goes with every one of us before we die. When we die, it goes with us, invested on a daily basis till the day of judgment. Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us minimum 3 life insurances. Number one, sadaqa jariya. When you make a sadaqa jariya, when you die, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is investing it for you till the day of judgment. And angels go to you, to your grave, to inform you, even to the barzakh, telling you how good you are because you have put X number of dollars as sadaqa jariya. A sadaqa is not a regular sadaqa. Regular sadaqa, a needy person, you give. But sadaqa jariya means you help to build a masjid, you help to build a hospital, a school, an orphanage, a cemetery, anything that stays after we die, that is the best sadaqa. And the angels are coming to you on behalf of Allah, how nice you are. And Jannah is waiting for you. Number two, ilm yuntafa'u bih, your knowledge. All of us are highly educated, mashaAllah. When you die, what is your knowledge? What is your knowledge? Where is your knowledge? In the grave, it's over. Why don't you put your knowledge in an audio, in a video, in internet, in world web, anywhere in the world, so as people will raise their hand and make rahmah on you. If you can, why don't you share it with others and invest in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number three, walad salih yad'ulah. A loving child, when you die, they pray 5 times a day and they raise their hand and say, Rabbi firli wa li walidayya wa lil mu'minina yawma yaqumus. Honest to God, if you do not now train your boys and girls to pray 5 times a day, and if you husbands, you fathers, if you are not going to pray 5 times a day, and you are not going to be a role model to your wife and to your children, don't think that your children are going to listen to you or to your wife. Even if you husbands, if you are not going to tell your wife, come let's pray together as jama'ah, why she should look at you as a role model? You are not a role model to her. Because you don't obey Allah. Why should she obey you when you don't obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And don't feel bad about it. You obey Allah, she will obey you. You don't obey Allah, she is not going to obey you. And therefore, How nice would it be when you raise your family on a daily basis? I know you are busy, 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 everybody is busy, but at least you can pray with your family once a day. Either Fajr or Maghrib and Isha, or Isha at least. If you don't do it once a day, I feel sorry for you and for your children. If your children are not practicing Islam, because you are not one family. The American proverb says, the family that eat together, stay together. I said, no. The family that pray together, stay together. The family that pray together, eat together, come to the masjid together, as husband, wife and children to the masjid, then they stay together. And if you go for Umrah and Hajj together, that is the family that stay together. Think it over. وَلَا الصَّالِحْ يَدْعُوا لَهُ. Let me finish with some ahadith. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us also, إِنَّ مِمَّا يَلْحَقُ الْمُؤْمِنِ مِنْ عَمَلِهِ وَحَسَنَاتِهِ بَعْدُ مَوْتِهِ علما علمه ونشره أو ولدا صالحا تركه أو مصحفا ورثه أو مسجدا بناه أو بيتا بناه لابن السبيل أو نهرا أكراه أو صدقة أخرجها من ماله في صحته وحياته تلحقه بعد من بعد ماته. Beautiful hadith. Seven items that will go with you to your grave. Number one is علم, knowledge. Number two, a loving child who make dua. Number three, مصحف, to make people to learn Quran. It's not giving paper mushaf. It means you educate children, make memory of Quran. Even if you allow one child or one human being to memorize one ayah, one surah, one is better than zero. The other thing, masjid. You have to build a masjid. Or build a musafir khane. Musafir khane like a motel fi sabilillah for all the travelers. Anyone who comes crisscross and he doesn't have a place, instead of putting them in a motel and whatnot for non-Muslim, put them in a Muslim motel. Or a river, dig water and bring water to them. Or sadaqah, you make it before you die. Otherwise, if we are busy with our life, then remember what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in Surah Al-Takathur, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, ألهاكم التكاثر حتى زرتم المقابر. You are busy producing money, producing children, producing equipment, producing everything till you go to the grave. Then at that time it's too much. Remember, any time you take care of anything, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, وَمَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَلِأَنفُسِكُمْ وَمَا تُنْفِقُونَ إِلَّا ابْتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ اللَّهِ وَمَا تُنْفِقُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ يُوَفَّ إِلَيْكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تُظْلَمُونَ. Anything that you are going to spend, good, it's for you. Means you are, somebody is inspiring you, motivating you to open an account for you in your bank. Which bank? Bank of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All these banks of America are useless for us. The only bank that is useful for us is the bank of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And any time if somebody inspiring us, motivating us, telling us to do fi sabilillah for the love of Allah, to help others who are less fortunate than us, they are helping you to open an account for you in your name with the account of Allah. You refuse. I can't help except to cry for the love of Allah and for the sake of us. And Allah also says, وَمَا تُنْفِقُ مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَإِنَّ اللَّهِ بِهِ عَلِيمٌ. Whatever you are spending in the name of Allah, Allah knows exactly. The last hadith, I say it, عن Ibn Mas'ud رضي الله عنه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, لا حسد إلا في اثنين. You want to be jealous of somebody? Be jealous in a way, in the positive. Or envy. You want to envy somebody? Yes. Who are they? Two people, groups of people. رجل آتاه الله مالا فسلطه على هلكته في الحق. A group of individuals that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them فلوس, money. They are ready to go and gamble. They are ready to go and do anything in it to lose it or to do it. It's their business, it's their money, whatever they want. And they said no. They spend it in the fi sabilillah. Those group of people, you should feel envy. Ya Allah, give them credit, and I wish I am like them, have money in order that I can spend it fi sabilillah. But don't be like Qarun, and don't be like Thalaba, whom Allah blessed them with money and they backed up. But I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that everyone should have enough to give away. Number two, وَرَجُلٌ آتَاهُ اللَّهُ حِكْمَةً فَوَيَقْضِي بِهَا وَيُعَلِّمُهَا. Another group of people that Allah gave them wisdom. And they are using their wisdom to help people, to show them the right way to come close to Allah. And I hope and I pray, while we are here in the house of Allah, on Friday, it's a sacred day, doors of heaven are open, and dua is being accepted. Where in the world you see non-Muslims in their congregation sitting on the floor other than Muslims? I went to so many places, to Christians, to Jews, to Hindus, to Buddhists and what not. I never saw any group of religious people who sit on the floor for the congregation as humble as Muslims. Nowhere I have seen group of religious people, they will put their face on the floor as a sign of humbleness for Allah to crush their ego, except Muslims. Huh? Medical doctors, PhDs, professors, MDs, and business people, students. You see how all of us sitting together humbly on the floor, and all of us put our face on the floor as a sign of obedience to Allah. You should be grateful that Allah loves you, that He inspired you, He made you to come to the house of Allah. Shaitan could have told you, no, stay in your business. I'm preoccupied today, I'll come next week, and you die tonight and you lost everything. You should be grateful to Allah that Allah has inspired you to come to the house of Allah and sit on the floor for the love of Allah. So while you are sitting peacefully, raise your hand and make dua for you, for your father's mother, for every believer and faithful anywhere in the world to guide us all. فيفوز المستغفرين استغفروا ربكم انه كان غفارا. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاه والسلام على رسول الله وعلى اله وصحبه ومن والاه. اما بعد، يقول الله عز وجل في القران الكريم: ان الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا ايها الذين امنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى ال سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا ابراهيم وعلى ال سيدنا ابراهيم، وبارك اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى ال سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا ابراهيم وعلى ال سيدنا ابراهيم في العالمين، انك حميد مجيد. وارض اللهم عن الاربعه خلفاء ابي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، وعن ازواج محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وعن الصحابه والتابعين والتابعين باحسان الى يوم الدين. ربنا اتنا في الدنيا حسنه وفي الاخره حسنه وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد اذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمه انك انت الوهاب. ربنا هب لنا من ازواجنا وذرياتنا قره اعين واجعلنا المتقين اماما. ربنا اجعلنا مقيمي الصلاه ومن ذريتنا ربنا وتقبل دعاء. ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا والمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب. اللهم احينا مسلمين، اللهم امتنا مؤمنين، اللهم احشرنا مع الانبياء والشهداء والصالحين. اللهم من اراد بالاسلام والمسلمين خيرا فوفقه لكل خير، ومن اراد بهم شرا فخذه اخذ عزيز مقتدر يا رب العالمين. اللهم منا الدعاء ومنك الاجابه، فتقبل منا دعاءنا واغفر لنا خطايانا انك انت الغفور الرحيم. وصل وسلم وبارك اللهم على محمد النبي الامي وعلى اله وصحبه وسلم، الحمد لله رب العالمين. عباد الله، ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون.